الحمد لله رب العالمين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله نشهد ونؤكد بأنه بلغ رسالة وعاد الأمانة ونصح أمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين أما بعد قال الله تعالى في كتاب الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتون إلا وأنتم مسلمون واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون My dear respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, we respectable elders and beloved listeners, we start by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make it possible for meet up in a beautiful place like this, on a beautiful day like this, when a Yawmul Jum'ah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting the barakah of this day. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for accept of gratitude of the extent to Allah. We pray for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in family and in companions, and we ask Allah for bless them all. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for make we the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A part of being the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we ensure that we prepare ourselves for the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also ensure that we try as much as possible for pass the test of life by the will of Allah. For indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell me in the Quran that the reason why we come in this particular place known as dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that for there it comes to be through test, so that when we pass this test, we will rest yawmul qiyamah by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almighty Allah say in Surah Al-Mulk, تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Allah out of his power that he creates die and he creates life, why did Allah do this one? It's in our contest which among us will engage in good deeds, which among us will go ensure and try for pass the test, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already don't decree that certainly and surely it will continue for test we until we return to Ram, until it sends, until it detects subhanallah, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the one that will surely pass in test. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make we among the one that where they pass the test of life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell me in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. Almighty Allah clearly tell me in the Quran that certainly and surely it will test we with different tests. It will test we in different ways. It will give we as a test. It will take away as a test by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Almighty Allah highlights the test them, where it will test each and every one of we. Some they go through one, some they go through more by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah say, among the test them where it decide for test we, he say min al-khawfi. Allah will test we with the test of fear. My beloved brothers and sisters, we all go agree that particular test today, as we sit on here, and those listening to us around the globe by the will of Allah, will agree that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala part of his test, not the test of fear. Subhanallah, most of us today are afraid of the coronavirus. That is also part of the test of Allah. There are times when they fear for things that will not happen yet. When they fear the unknown and the known as well, it is part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why Almighty Allah foresee whether that he will afraid or will afraid the coronavirus. Subhanallah. We ask Allah for make way among the one them when they pass this particular test, the test of fear. Because most of us, they go through English school, based on the location of this masjid, we must have read, subhanallah, that it is said in the book where some of we don't read, Julius Caesar, that coward died many times before their death. Subhanallah, when you are afraid, sometime you die before the real die they come. This is part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order for see, in order for realize, subhanallah, which among us will turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we are in a chaotic situation, in a situation wherein each and every one, they suspect another, Allah will foresee whether we will turn to them or we will turn away from them. Subhanallah. When we fear the coronavirus, we put the mask by the will of Allah. We wash our hands them by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And above all, we respect social distancing by the will of Allah. All of these na'a means, who that they give the protection, it's Allah. فَلْيَعْبُدْ رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعِهِ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, E Allah, the inga the power, for protect we, subhanallah, from everything we would afraid. Whenever we put on a mask, we need to realize that na Allah, they protect, subhanallah. Whenever we respect a social distance, we need to realize that when it comes to protection, it belongs to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, certainly and surely, I will test you now with the test of fear. من الخوف والجوع والنخس من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, the next test, I will test you now with the test of hunger. This is the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes Allah they test we by not having even the feeling for it. Subhanallah. There are times we gain the capacity for it, but Almighty they block we not for able it. This is part of the plan of Allah. This is part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that whenever we eat, we thank Allah, believing that it is Allah that in grant you the permission for it. Otherwise, they will serve you the food, but Allah will hold the hand, and above all, it will hold the throat, no ways for letting food pass. That is the power of Allah. Almighty Allah, I will test you now with a test of hunger, and I will test you now with a test of reduction of wealth, reduction of inner life, reduction of plantations, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, give good news to those who be patient. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test we, the aim is nafole, we ensure that we get a reward out of the test of Allah. That is why Almighty Allah say, give good news to the one that will be a patient. Alladina iza asabatuhum musiba qalu inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The one that will be sick, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test them with a test, then they talk to Allah. They say, certainly and surely, we belong to Allah. And we go return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we belong to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do to we, waiting he wants for do to we. We don't get any power for ask Allah why he do so. La yus'alu amma yaf'al, wa hum yus'alun. We don't get any power for ask Allah, Allah, why you bring corona? Allah, why you bring this sickness? Allah, why you bring this one or that one? But Allah, get the power for us, we, why we not rely upon them completely when he bring the test. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make we among the one them, where they be a patient in trying times. For indeed, these are trying times for us in Sierra Leone, by the will of Allah, at a particular point to be get, subhanallah, the happiness in our hearts, thinking that it is over. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But suddenly, we go back, subhanallah, making masks compulsory. Why? Because cases and they come up. This is part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for protect me, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for grant protection to all those who struggle around the globe due to the coronavirus or whatever illness or sickness, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell me in the Quran that no matter how much we close to Ra, no matter how much we worship Him, He still will test me. Allah say in Surah Al-Ankabut, He say, أحاسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, if you think say because of the prayer fighting in Salah, because you believe in Allah, because of the give charity, because of the fast month of Ramadan, and some of us by the will of Allah don't go Hajj, and some they plan for go Hajj by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you think say because of all the good deeds they are, we think say Allah no go test me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, surely I go test you now. Why? Because I don't test people them before now. People they will be far, far more better than you now. In terms of spirituality, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, why are they test? I want to know the one they were truthful when it comes to the kalima, the one they will completely rely upon me, and the one they will lie when it comes to kalima. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect me. My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put examples in the Quran how He tests people in the past. People were far more better than us. That is why Almighty Allah says, telling the Prophet alayhi salatu salam, He says, فَقُصُصِ الْقَصَصِ لَأَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Explain to them the stories or the narration of the Quran in order for them to learn a lesson from the previous people by the will of Allah. My beloved brothers and sisters, there will be people who will be far more better in spirituality than us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them so much. He tests them when it comes to wealth and health by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One example is a Nabi Ayyub alayhi salatu salam, a prophet known as Prophet Job in English language by the will of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them. Imagine a prophet of Allah. Almighty Allah take his wealth away from her. He take only beginning away from her. And above all, he take his health away from her. A prophet of Allah. A man who was chosen by Allah. A man who delivered the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almighty Allah still be test them with difficulty. Subhanallah. But when Allah test them, because if he rely in Allah, he realize it, he continue to be a patient. He ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help. And Almighty Allah help him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remain in sickness. And He grant a wealth again by the will of Allah. And Almighty Allah says in the Quran, He said, Inna wajadnahu sabiran ni'mal abd innahu awwab. Ayyub alayhi salatu salam, when we test them, we meet them say, now one of who slaves them, subhanallah, will be a patient, innahu awwab, with all the tests. If he continue to turn to me, Allah, he not turn away from me, subhanallah. He seek so much, Allahu Akbar, so much that in Bodhirati, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asked Allah, he said, Ya Allah, spear me tongue and spear me heart. Spear me tongue because I therefore glorify you, and spear me heart because I therefore remember you. Ya Allah, spear their organs they are for me. No matter what you do upon me, I will forget through this test. How many of us today Muslim then? Today some of we, if we ate out for 3 days or 2 days, subhanAllah, we will say this is not for nothing. And if we go to that part, the enemies at work, may Allah forgive me. Small test we did to Muriman, subhanAllah. May Almighty Allah grant you guidance. Some of we small sickness of the family they sick, we take them out of coverage area for go seek the help, subhanAllah. When it comes to therapy, my beloved brothers and sisters, true therapy belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you go to the doctor, because of your health, you need to realize, you need to concur and conclude and accept that when it comes to shifa, when it comes to medicine, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The doctor, the asababu, used by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah for make we among the one that will rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter how difficult the situation is. There are some of us who have been tested when it comes to begin, subhanAllah. Some people don't get married for a year, two, subhanAllah, or more. Up to now, they're not born beginning, subhanAllah. That is part of the test of Allah. You know why? Because when it comes to begin, subhanAllah, it belongs to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَفَرَعَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ
أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون؟ Why we not look and learn lesson from the water all that they emit? Subhanallah. Now, una they turn the water to a human being, or na me Allah they turn her to a human being? The answer is Allah. Not to the attire we drink, subhanallah. Not to the milk or the granite or jam. It belongs to Allah. لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ يَحَبُّ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا وَيَحَبُّ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ ذُكُورًا أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكُرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَكِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, the sovereignty, all power of the heavens and the earth, it belongs to Allah. Because it belongs to Allah, it creates how he wants. It gifts who they want, girl picking one or more by the will of Allah. And it gifts who they want, boy picking or more boys by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or it mix for who they want, boys and girls by the will of Allah. And it creates who that he wants permanently barren, subhanallah. No matter how the game play, you know, they even nakba, not for talk about for school. It is part of the plan of Allah. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created human being with permanently barren by the will of Allah. No matter the medication where he's sick, subhanallah, it won't be possible. Why? Because it is part of incest for the Jannah by the will of Allah. Allah will foresee whether it will turn to Ram or it will turn away from her. Whether you believe in the rope for time they respond, thinking that this rope now they bring the beginning, or whether you will rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after trying halal means. What in a halal means? If you don't marry and begin okay, part of the test of Allah is for you to go seek medication in a halal way. Go see a medical doctor by the will of Allah for check you internally if you are okay. And the husband also need to go and check internally if he is okay. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thereafter, una do exactly what in there in una capacity in terms of intimacy by the mercy of Allah. And thereafter, una make dua whilst una rely in Allah. Whilst una rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't just sit and say, subhanallah, I cannot do anything. Yes, there is something you can do in your capacity within the context of halal by the will of Allah. But no go to looking grown person for go looking like grown for you. No go to Moriman subhanallah for go looking grown for you as to why you never begin. It belongs to Allah. Go in a halal way. Do not go in a haram way. Why? It is part of the test of Allah. May Almighty Allah grant you guidance. May Allah make we among the one them where they pass the test by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, a clear example I want to give to you for those of us who are still awaiting, subhanallah, still await the fruit of the womb by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at an example of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. An example of Zakariya alayhi salatu wa salam, subhanallah, a prophet of Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, the beloved of Allah. Almighty Allah choose him, he said, this man is my friend. But you know what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not here begin quick. This time, my friend, imagine Allah in friend. He said, I choose this man as my friend. But he hold on waiting your friend wants. Subhanallah. For quite a long time. Quite a long time. Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam got married and his first wife, subhanallah, not deliver early. Allah delayed them. He delayed them. He delayed them, subhanallah. But still Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam be returned to Allah. He not turn away from Allah. He asked Almighty Allah, he said, Rabbi, habli min as-salihin. Ya Allah, bless me with a good child. Bless me with a good child. Almighty Allah said, at a particular point, فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him with a blessed child known as Ismail alayhi salatu wa salam. Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam also was tested by Allah, a prophet of Allah, Almighty Allah, hold on what he wants, subhanallah. At all age, his wife don't reach at an age. Normally for us, we say menopause. But at that point, this woman, he don't pass menopause. In fact, he don't reach menostop, subhanallah. He don't reach menostop at an age wherein a woman not even expect for born again, subhanallah. That is when Allah bless her with begin. Allahu Akbar. That is when Allah bless her with begin. Subhanallah. When Zakariya alayhi salatu salam raised his hat and his hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
is ya Rabbi, la tazarni fardan wa anta khairul warithin. Ya Allah, no left me barren. You are the best of bestower, of inheritor. Subhanallah. Ya Allah, bless me with a good child. Almighty Allah, bless our begin at all age. My beloved brothers and sisters, those of us who are here, where they struggle in your matrimonial homes them, subhanallah, when it comes to one begin, after I don't try in a halal way, still the begin yet for come, rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That test might be a means for you for enter inside Jannah. If at all you be a patient by the mercy of Allah. For indeed, Almighty Allah says in the Quran, Inna Allah ma'as-sabirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in day who the one them, where they be a patient. We ask Allah for make we among the one them, where they be a patient, especially in trying times like this, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah make we among the one them, where they rely upon He alone, without we no associates partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah strengthen we, and may Allah take we life in this beautiful deen. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Do ask Allah for forgiveness, hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive we and He will delete your sins and completely. Astaghfirullah. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa bihi nasta'in wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah wa ala ahlihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa ba'd. My dear respectable brothers and sisters in Islam, respectable elders, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we pray for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in family and in companions, and we ask Allah for bless them all and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for make we the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Part of being the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and for ensure say we be a patient in trying times by the will of Allah. For indeed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith he say, Inna Allah azza wa jal iza ahabba abdan ibtala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let a slave, when Allah love a person, when He love in creature, He detest them more. The more Allah love you, then the more He detest you more. You know why? Because He want to grant you Jannah by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no way we will enter inside Jannah without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not test you. Allah said, no ways. Before they enter inside Jannah, I will test you for ensure that you are a candidate who is suitable for enter inside Jannah by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Am hasibtum an tadkhulu al-jannah unatim fasirna who enter inside Jannah. Wa lama ya'tikum ladhina khalaw min qablikum masatuhum ba'sa'u wa dharra'u wa zulzilu hatta yaqulu rasul wal ladhina amanu ma'ahu. Mata Nasrullah, Allah inna Nasrullah al-Qarib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, He said, if you think for say, when you enter inside Jannah, if you enter inside Jannah free of charge, just walking, subhanallah, sluggishly and enter inside Jannah. Allah said, no, you know it happened that way. When I teach you to enter inside Jannah, we're waiting to meet the previous people. No meet tonight. Allah say, I touch them with difficulty. I touch them with sickness, subhanallah, with hardship, hatta until Yaqul Rasul, until the messenger at that time. And those who believe, they ask a big question. They say, Mata Nasrullah, when is the help of Allah coming? When the help of Allah will come? And Almighty Allah respond, He say, Inna Nasrullah al-Qarib. Certainly and surely, the help of Allah it is very, very close. Subhanallah. The whole day in a tight situation, not only in Sierra Leone, the entire globe, they're in a difficult situation. Subhanallah, we have a mini curfew. There are people that we get monthly curfew due to the coronavirus. Subhanallah, things have become difficult that all of us, subhanallah, or some of us will start asking, when is this going to end? When is the corona going to end? Subhanallah, Allah grant me the answer. Do not worry. Inna Nasrullahi al-Qarib. The help of Allah is coming very soon by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Almighty Allah for bringing assistance upon we. For indeed, it is only by the will of Allah. It is only by the power of Allah we will go through this particular trial. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala end this trial out of His mercy. For indeed, Almighty Allah, إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends for do anything, He doesn't say be and it is.
My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمْ مُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ. Allah said, will continue for testuna until I know the one them where they strive sincerely towards me and the one them where they be a patient. May Almighty Allah make we among the one them where they be a patient by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, the test of Allah will continue for come upon we by the will of Allah. What you need now for prepare by the mercy of Allah in order for pass the test with a flying color by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Almighty Allah tell me the secret where they use for pass in test. The Quran is so beautiful, subhanallah, that it grants you all the solution. Allah say, look, I get for test you. This is not the solution to that test. What you go use for pass me test? Almighty Allah say, Istainu bi sabri wa salah. You want to pass me test? Seek me assistance, subhanallah. Seek me assistance in two things, in patience and in prayers. Whenever Allah tests me or He tests you, and you truly want to pass the test, we need two weapons. One, bearing patience. Number two, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed Almighty Allah, huwa sami'un, alimun, qareebun, basirun, mujibu da'wata da'i. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the yari, in the siwi, in obatwi, in the very close, and in the answer the call of the caller, subhanallah. When in the answer, not to your business. How in the answer, not to your business. What did Allah say? Almighty Allah say, will call upon me. Subhanallah. Allah say, will call upon me. When we engage in salah, we are sincere in salah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that salah will protect we from going out of coverage area. May Almighty Allah grant you guidance. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect we. So my beloved brothers and sisters, no matter how difficult the situation is, no matter how difficult the sickness is, never ever throw away your salah. The true iman is when you never walk again. You never walk again, you don't have the bed, but you still eager for pray. That is true iman. That is true iman. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. There are people that when they get small trial, he say, me minor sweet. In fact, me minor sweet for pray self because I get a good problem. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. May Allah grant you guidance. My beloved brothers and sisters, when you have a problem, the more problem you get, the more you for increase in the salah. The more the sickness intensify, now the more you for ensure so you pray. And Islam make it very easy for we through the lips of the Prophet alayhi salam. He says, "Sallu qa'ima fa in lam tastati fa qa'ida fa in lam tastati fa ala jam." Pray, you tin up. If there is a reason due to sickness or any difficulty, make you never tin up. The Prophet alayhi salam say, "Pray, you sit up." If there is anything also that block you, for let never sit up for pray. Due to sickness or whatever shari'i reason, the Prophet alayhi salam say, pray where you don't. Subhanallah. Why? Because you need prayer at all times. No excuse. So in that trying time, say, my beloved brothers and sisters, let's be a patient and pray more by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call on Allah more. Let's come closer to Allah. Wasjud wa qatarib. Let me prostrate to Allah and come closer to Allah. The more closer we come to Allah, now the more we get through solution by the mercy of Allah. But when we rely in our senses, we rely on our technology, subhanallah, today we we'll agree that even with technology, no matter how sophisticated with technology don't grow, my beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can still overrun the technology of the whole dunya. Subhanallah. Today, doctors they say there is nothing we can do. Subhanallah. We still they find the cure. And today, the cure, subhanallah, according to news, has been found already. There are still people that were still skeptical. Subhanallah. May Almighty Allah grant you guidance. You know why? It is because the true solution, they come from Huda, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in difficult times, in trying times, let's be a patient, my beloved brothers and sisters. There are some of us who study so much, we read a lot,
What's the great one we expect? We not get them. Be a patient. Allah knows exactly. By the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, work hard and continue for pray more. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, Allah will grant you victory. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not give up. There are those who don't go for us. One, twice, subhanallah. Up to now, they never get a requirement. Be a patient. If you don't work hard and up to now you don't get a requirement, be a patient. Inna Allah. Ma'as-sabirin. Allah know why you don't get the requirement after all the halal efforts when you don't make, after all the dua, Allah knows, do not give up. For those of us who want a job and up to now we don't get a job, subhanallah, we don't send, we CV them, up to now not calling for interview, be a patient. My beloved brother, my beloved sister, you don't try your best by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows why you don't grant you the job. Sometimes Allah not grant you the job because you have to protect your iman. Some of we, the job they won't apply for, if we get them, we left for pray. Allah say, look, me slave, I like you so much. I know they give you that job. Why? Because if I give him, you go left for Kana Mosque. May Almighty Allah protect me. There are times what you want, if Allah give him, we go out of coverage area. May Almighty Allah protect me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرُ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرُّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 216, Almighty Allah say, there are times waiting you want, what you want so much in your life, it's not good for you. SubhanAllah. There are times what you hate so much, what you hate so much, that ain't good for you. Allah, na he know, we not know. Let we rely to the knower of everything by the mercy of Allah. Do not give up. Subhanallah. Stand up. Rely on Allah. Be a patient and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hold on to your salah. Inshallah. Allah will grant you success by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almighty Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, isbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu wa attaqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. Oh, now we believe, una be a patient. Una excel in patience. Meaning, una sit belt inside the vehicle of patience. Subhanallah. Wattakullaha, una be conscious of Allah. La'allakum tuflihun. So that una will be successful by the mercy of Allah. When we be a patient and we conscious of Allah, worship Allah alone, inshallah, Allah will grant you the success. May Almighty Allah grant you the success. Especially in this trying time, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The brothers them in a different part of the globe where they struggle due to the coronavirus. May Almighty Allah ease their fears. May Almighty Allah end the coronavirus by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever to one is good for we, may Almighty Allah grant we. Whatever to one is good for we, may Allah change that for we. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you contentment by the mercy of Allah. May Allah grant you patience upon every condition by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah grant you the reward of patience by the will of Allah. May Almighty Allah make you among the one where you draw closer and closer to Him. In every situation, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah bless this nation. May Allah bless the leaders them. May Allah guide leaders them to policies that will lead to the progress of this nation. May Allah protect them from policies that will lead to the backpedaling of this nation. May Allah bless you, imams them. May Allah grant you a job, you know, to put you inside the deen. For those, subhanAllah, who they seek for marriage, may Allah grant you a good spouse. For those who don't marry, may Allah bless you beginning. May Allah bless you now with good beginning. By the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who get beginning, we're not enough the way how Allah wants them for enough. May Allah bring them inside the deen. By the mercy of Allah, may Allah forgive the shortcomings and the long comings. May Allah take your life in this beautiful deen. We begin them with brothers and sisters them. Whether in academic struggle, may Allah grant you now flying colors. By the mercy of Allah, may Allah bless you teachers and ustaz them. By the mercy of faith, wa tawalana fi man tawalait, wa barik lana fi ma ata. وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت انك تقدر بالحق ولا يقدر عليك لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا من الظالمين حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل ولا حول لنا ولا قوه الا بالله العظيم اللهم زدنا ولا تنقصنا اللهم زدنا علما نافعا وقلبا خاشيا ولسانا ذاكرا وعملا صالحا متقبلا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم ارفع عنا الغلا والوباء والزنا والزلازل والمهن وسوء فتنه ما ظهر منها وما بطن برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين المسلمين حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل ولا حول لنا ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم اللهم انصر من نصر الدين واخذل من خذل المسلمين آمين يا رب العالمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد سبحان الله بحمده سبحانك اللهم بحمده نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.